What's up, y'all? It's your man Jay Sands. Sands on sports, hip hop, and sports entertainment at its finest. That's right, y'all. The big kid is at it again. And we're going to start off with the NFL. That's right, y'all. Week one is right around the corner. And we're going to go over all the matchups. And matter of fact, we're going to focus on the quarterbacks because you probably don't know who's QB in every team. So check it out. The first game is the Saints versus the Packers. And here we got the Super Bowl champions starting off the NFL season versus Super Bowl champions of 2 years ago. Stellar QBs in this game, so there will be a lot of sky miles for the pigskin. This is going to be Drew Brees versus Aaron Rodgers. The next game is Atlanta versus Chicago. Matt Ryan, he has more tools on offense this year, which will probably take his game to the next level. The last thing I remember about Jay Cutler is the disappearance in the playoff game, and all the Chicago Bears fans were mad. The next game is a big Ohio matchup. We got the Bengals versus the Browns. Now, the Bengals are the worst run franchise in the NFL. The Browns, well, they may surprise some people this year. A new coach, so hopefully it's not the same old Browns. And Colt McCoy, all he really has to do is just manage the offense. Then we got Buffalo at Kansas City. Now, Ryan Fitzpatrick, he threw for over 3,000 yards last year, which is, you know, kind of sucker fair, but can he do that again? Matt Castle, he has a lot of talent around him. He just has to show that he's ready to take that next step to become the franchise quarterback that they want him to be for the Chiefs. And then we got the Eagles versus the Rams. Mike Vick, he got that long bread a couple days ago. The second time in his life, he got $100 million, but now he has to play like a $100 million quarterback. Sam Bradford, he had a nice rookie season. I look for improvement from the young gunslinger. Then let's move into Detroit versus Tampa Bay. Okay, now this is supposed to be the year for the Lions. Matt Stafford, he just has to stay healthy and he'll be fine. Now, Josh Freeman from Tampa Bay, he's on the road to being one of the premier quarterbacks in the NFL. And this year will determine if he's going to take a detour or not. Then we got Tennessee at Jacksonville. Matt Hasselbeck is a vet QB on his last leg, looking for a ring, who is very happy they just signed Chris Johnson. I haven't heard much about David Gerrard for the Jacksonville Jaguars. He had a horrible season last year, and this year he has Lane Gabbert looking over his shoulder. And then we got Pittsburgh at Baltimore. My pick for the game of the week, we got Big Ben, who's back after a Super Bowl loss, and we got Joe Flacco, who's back after a playoff loss to the Steelers. So my prediction is somebody's gonna get hurt, so please pray for them all. And then let's move into the Colts and the Texans. Sound like a gunfight at the OK Corral. Is Peyton Manning playing in this game? More than likely, probably he's going to play. That's Peyton Manning. He's the Lou Gehrig, the Kyle Ripken of the NFL. He's going to Brett Favre. He's going to play in this game. Now, Matt Schaub, he better hope Aaron Foster's hammy heals, or he will be spending the day on his back, which is not a good thing if you're a quarterback in the NFL. And then we got the Giants at the Redskins, another division rivalry right here. Matter of fact, big up to the NFL for having all these first week division jump offs. That's probably an NFL fan's dream right there. But anyway, all I'm gonna say is Eli threw a lot of interceptions last year, but he still has that Super Bowl bling, and in the NFL, that's the only thing that matters. Rex Grossman, well, we all know he has a powerful arm, but he might be with the worst run organization outside of the Cincinnati Bengals. Yeah, I said the Cincinnati Bengals suck. Then we got Seattle at San Fran. Tavares Jackson, listen to me close. This is your last chance to make it as a starter in the NFL, so you better do something because you look kind of during the preseason. And Alex Smith for the San Francisco 49ers, take what I said to Tavares Jackson and multiply it by 100. Then we got Minnesota at San Diego. Donovan McNabb has a new team, but the same dream to get that Super Bowl bling. But check it out now. He has all the players around him. He just has to play stellar at the quarterback position. Now on the other side, Phillip Rivers, this is supposed to be his year. Yeah, right. It was supposed to be his year last year, and the year before that, and the year before that. So I'm not buying all this Phillip Rivers hype. Now let's move into Carolina at Arizona. Cam Newton is starting as a rookie. Now that's good and that's bad. The game is so fast, and he is so fast that Cam might be using his legs a lot in this first game. Now the darling of the offseason for free agency was Kevin Cobb. He got paid, got a starting job. Now will he perform? That's the big question. A newly signed Larry Fitzgerald will help that movement a lot. Then we got the Cowboys versus the Jets. Tony Romo. Okay, he finally won a playoff game. So what? The Cowboys, they win Super Bowl rings. You feel what I'm saying? And that's what he must do to complete his legacy. Mark Sanchez, he just has to build on what he's already accomplished because he's done a lot of things in his first few years as the quarterback for the Jets. Then we got the Patriots at the Dolphins. Tom Brady, well, he does what he does and does what he does very well. Win, baby, win. Ocho Cinco, he's going to be a great addition to the offense. But you know how Brady does it. He likes to spread the wealth around, so everybody's going to touch the rock. Now, Chad Henne, he's probably on the bottom of the barrel of the list of stars this year, so he has a lot to prove. And last, we got the Raiders at Denver. Jason Campbell, he's going to surprise a lot of people this year and finally live up to his billing that we saw when he came out of Auburn. Kyle Orton, he's a solid quarterback. I don't know what the hype is about Tim Tebow because Kyle Orton wins games and he doesn't get enough credit for winning. I mean, that's why we play the games, right? To win! But yo, you know how I do it on Sands on Sports. Always have the hot, interesting guests. And this week, I got my man, DJ Bonics. That's right, y'all, from the 412. This is Jay Sands. This is Sands on Sports. And we'll be back, y'all. Peace. Yo, what's up, y'all? It's your man, Jay Sands, Sands on Sports. I got a special guest from the home team, my man, DJ Bonics. What's
what
up, brother?
What up, DJ
Thank you
Bonics.
For coming on the show.
What's going on, my man?
Definitely. So we're going to run through this real quick, man.
I'm nervous about this.
Nah, man, you're good, man. You're good, man. You're from a sports city, so we're going to rep it. Right. Check it out, fam. We're going to first talk about your favorite team.
Okay.
I already know, but let's give it to the people. Baseball.
I mean, a baseball? All right, Pirates and Philly. Right. Like, you may not know, though. I was born in Philly.
Yeah,
I was born in Philly.
Yeah.
So, you know, I got Philly. Pirates love. Pirates are always bad, so.
This is going to be interesting.
I don't love baseball,
yeah.
So that's.
What about football then?
You know, my AFC team, of course, is the Steelers.
Oh, you got two teams.
My NFC's got to be the Eagles, but of course, Steelers.
Two team guy.
I know, so.
All right, okay. What about hockey?
Hockey. I like the Penguins, so.
Penguins, okay.
I got to go with the Pens on that.
And who you got who?
Basketball?
Yeah.
I'm a Barkley fan.
Okay.
So I love the Sixers. I love Phoenix. I don't love Houston. I love Barkley, though.
I can dig it. All right, well, let's talk about
greatest sports. Player of all time.
Barkley is the greatest player of all time.
All time.
Not Michael Jordan.
No, Charles Barkley.
All right, okay. Well, we're going to leave that.
Where's Jordan at now, man? Barkley, he's getting that money still.
But that ain't got to do with skills.
I know.
But we're going to leave that alone. Talk about sports you play coming up. You play any sports coming up?
I played basketball, believe it or not, when I was 12, I was a center on my travel team. I was number 34, you know what it is? it was like, I tried it in high school, but you know, right. I was a fat kid.
Okay, all right. Well, hey, man, check it out. You were a big part of the movement, man, with the Steelers going to Super Bowl, man.
Yeah.
What did you think? What was that like, fam? You know, you was there. You seen all that. Were you at the AFC Championship?
Yeah, we performed at the AFC Championship with Wiz. Like, shout out to the Steelers because they let me. I'm like their unofficial DJ.
No doubt.
All the warm-up music for
them. The Steelers, y'all.
And, you know, I've done their fashion show.
Yeah.
You know, I've done the Rooney's little, their children's birthday party.
That's hot, brother. Like that. You know this is all hot stuff you're saying right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, yeah. No. Okay. So it's cool. Shout out to the Steelers. And it was awesome run. I mean, imagine what black and yellow probably still would have done well, but for have the team go to the Super Bowl during that whole time, that's magic.
That's right.
Man,
that's right. All right. Hey. What about the Buccos? We gotta talk about the Buccos, because that's my favorite team. If you didn't know, I love the Steelers, but my favorite team is the Buccos, man. So, what do you think about the Buccos this year?
I mean, I keep seeing, for some reason, every time I catch ESPN SportsCenter, there's always a Pirate highlight.
That's right.
So,
yeah,
you know,
some players on the team.
They're always fighting for 500, but, you know, that's better than doing totally shitty. So.
All right, no doubt. Well, hey, we're going to get out of here, man, but let the people know how to get in touch with you, your Twitter, your Facebook, all that, what you got going on,
got,
the mixtape.
I got a little mixtape with my man Jay Sands
that's
coming
right,
out. If you don't know
right.
about
K-R-S
my man Jay Sands,
that's coming out, definitely.
I bought like 4 Due Process 12 inches from Brave New World. My man Spar. Yes, I don't even know what Spar is.
Yeah, pick up the
so,
Spar.
You know, I bought this shirt for him. For
right. right.
Nah, but yeah, we're coming out with that mixtape.
That's right. KR Sands.
Yep, KR Sands, little old KRS-One, of course, my man Jay Sands.
That's right.
So big shout out to Pittsburgh, big shout out to Lone Cat, big shout out to
What are you doing in the DMV tonight,
yo, man?
Man,
this is this popping ass after party. Take a look right now.
Yeah.
We just did a show.
Popping off the buttons.
Yeah. Right. George Mason, so you know Pittsburgh's that's everywhere. Right. Mac Miller, big shout out to Mac Miller. Yeah. Wiz Khalifa.
That's right.
My man Jay Sands. Right.
Pittsburgh's in the
Pittsburgh
building.
Pittsburgh legend right here.
Yes, sir, man. You know we're in the building, yo. Well, yo, this is Jay Sands, DJ Bonics. This is Sands on Sports. He got to work, so we out of here. Peace.
My name is Olivia, and I'm watching Sands on Sports.
Big up to my man DJ Bonics. Thanks for coming on the show. I hope you got to hear the mixtape that me and him just dropped called KRS Sands. That's right, y'all. It's out there. You can check it out. Free download, free listens, all that. But yo, let's go into the question of the week. This is from my man Daryl Hudson in the ATL. He says, Jay Sands, you have the football on the 20, a minute left. Who do you go to, Big Ben or Mike Vick? Well, for me, you already know the answer to that. I'm going with my man Big Ben. I love Mike Vick, but we're going to Big Ben because we seen it done in the Super Bowl when San Antonio made that catch in the corner. So my answer is Big Ben. Now let's go to Who's Hot. We're going to take it to the D. That's right, y'all. My man Justin Verlander of the Detroit Tigers. He's 20-5 right now. First pitcher this year to win 20 games. He has a 2.38 ERA, and he is an MVP Cy Young contender for this year in the American League. So Justin Verlander, you're hot, baby. Now let's go to my pick of the week, and we're going to go to the city of Baltimore. That's right, y'all. 4-0. The Baltimore Grand Prix inaugural race. That's right, the first time they're going to run races downtown Baltimore, which is going to be crazy hill. And I'm going with my man, Marco Andretti. Okay, we're going to get out of here, but I want to let everybody know we're back. New music, new video, man, just all new everything. And also remember that we're trying to raise money with this mixtape me and Bonics got with a campaign called Bucks for Bonics, man. We're going to take this money, give it to the right people so they can do the right things with it. But yo, this is Jay Sands. This is Sands on Sports, and I'm out of here.